Daniel Quintero.
Good evening. My name is Dan Quintero. I'm a resident of the city. East Ramapo School District. I was here on the 18th, and I shared with this board that we had approached, a group of 15 families had approached the superintendent about the fact that our transportation was taken away from us 3 weeks before school finished in the 2014-15 school year. So the last 3 weeks, 15 families were scurrying around looking for transportation. But the insult to injury was that transportation was being taken away altogether as a result of a foil that was alluded to by Mr. Weisman. This foil, or these families, really want nothing to do with what's happening here politically. This board was elected to take care of the people. You're entrusted with what this population needs right here. And as the nice lady before me said, the insensitivity that is being shown is absurd. The lack of communication, the lack of trying to work with us to try and get non-public school kids to their schools who live in East Ramapo. For this board to think that these 15 plus families can just go out and seek transportation at an added cost, not to mention the time that it takes, is of the utmost insensitivity of anyone. How can you instill public trust and the people that you serve? The handbook, the New York State Education Handbook, clearly delineates that the superintendent has the discretion to provide transportation for families that live more than 15 miles away if it was being done for at least one of the previous 3 preceding years. But in addition to that, and since that last meeting, actually since early August, there has been a family that has moved in that is living less than 15 miles, the 15-mile threshold. But what we get back, again, is lip service. No, you didn't file in time. It's not gonna work. Or no, it's now 14.8 miles you have to. This just shows me that you're not trying to be helpful as a board. I'm appealing now to your public sense of right and wrong. I mean, you have that. This is not an issue of Jew against Gentile. This is about what's right. You're hearing many comparisons here of other groups getting transportation door to door, 50 miles away. You know what, personally, I don't care. What I care about is that I and the 15 families that I'm representing tonight are taxpayers who something very valuable is being ripped away from them. Their children are suffering, they're suffering, their jobs are suffering, not to mention the stress that they're going through. So a lot of them are single parents. And we have an elected board that has gone like this. You're throwing your hands up. This is unacceptable. We have a superintendent that's totally putting his retort in a rule that he has total discretion to override. And we know this. Quite frankly, you're treating the general public as non-educated people. It's horrific. So what I would hope, and really, this, I don't want to be contentious, being consensuous here, it doesn't accomplish anything. I'm appealing to your sense of right and wrong. Individuals that have gotten transportation, that have taken advantage of that's the only thing that they've taken advantage of from their school taxes, that they be able to take advantage of that moving forward. That their children can go to school in a safe bus on a daily basis, get to school on time, just like all the other kids in East Ramapo. Thank you.